Radio Cardiff 98.7 FM.
Good afternoon. You're listening to News, Views and Interviews on Radio Cardiff 98.7 FM. I'm Jane Morris and I'm joined on the line now by Royal broadcaster Jenny Bond. Hello.
Hello there.
How are you doing today?
I'm quite warm, actually, I must say, but it's lovely.
I almost feel like I'm talking to royalty, talking to you.
People always say things like that. Oh, it's just I'm so identified with the royal story, I think, because I've been, you know, as the BBC's royal correspondent for 14 years and then broadcasting and writing about them ever since. So, you know, going over 20 years now, you've heard me or seen my name associated with royal things, but I can assure you I am not royalty.
Oh, right, OK. So in your job, did you get to know them personally?
Well, you get to know them a bit, obviously, but not probably as well as people imagine, because the relationship between the royal family and the media is understandably and permanently, I think, strained. You know, really, they'd rather be supping with the devil than talking to a journalist. But they know that they have to. So, yes, I've met the Queen on many occasions and had a little chat, made a little joke, tried to make her laugh, you know. Never talked about anything of any real substance. I've had tea with Charles a few times at Highgrove, and that's been lovely. And I knew Diana pretty well, and we did talk about a lot of things which were very private. But generally, you know, it's a working relationship.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And of course, the new baby coming.
I know. Yes, we're all on watch for it. All my colleagues who are still employed as full-time royal correspondents are messaging me saying, oh, we're standing outside on the pavement waiting. So, yeah.
Babies come when they're going to come, don't they?
Exactly.
You can't decide, no.
And I reckon it might be late. First babies are often late.
But how are they going to announce it?
Well, I'm intrigued and a little bit surprised to find that they're going absolutely down the traditional route on the announcement. I mean, the monarchy and the palace are in touch with modern technology. They do have Facebook. They do tweet and Flickr and all the rest of it. But nevertheless, when the baby is born, the news will be typed up on a sheet of headed note paper. And then it'll be driven through the streets of London to Buckingham Palace, where it'll be placed on an easel and displayed to the crowds just behind the gates. And people will gaze at it and see the announcement of the birth, which I think it's the way that generations of royal births have been announced. But I was a little bit surprised that they were going to stick to that unique and old-fashioned but really rather charming tradition.
So they're not going to tweet it then?
Well, you know, I reckon they will. Mm-hmm. I think they will tweet and do it on Facebook and the website and everything else, but not until they've made it the formal announcement, which is just a little bit more personal, I suppose. And that's why a company called PaperShaker.com thought, well, that's an interesting little fact. Let's see how many people agree with it in this modern age. And so they did a survey, and the results have just come out, and 8 out of 10 people they questioned, 82%, said that they thought, you know, it would be impersonal, a bit crass. Actually, they said even gimmicky, too gimmicky to announce it on Twitter or Facebook before they did anything else. So that was quite a surprising finding, really.
Mm-hmm. There's going to be a lot of interest as well, because whether it's a boy or a girl, it will be third in line to the throne.
Yes, and about time, too, that they changed those silly rules of succession, which meant that, you know, if this child turned out to be a girl and then had a younger sibling who was a boy, then the boy would become sovereign eventually. I'm just delighted that that's been changed and we are now on an equal footing with the men. And, it's a historic moment that this little babe, whether it's a girl or a boy, will be sovereign one day. And I hope it is a girl, actually, because I think then we'll witness a true moment of history and a turning point in the monarchy and true evidence that it's moving with the times.
Mm-hmm. Do you think people care that much about the royals?
Do you know what? I think they do. Funnily enough, I did a debate the other day about whether the next royal baby should be crowned, and the opinion in the room, quite a number of people, was very much against the monarchy at the beginning. And I made a few quite salient points, I hope. And by the end of the debate, we turned it completely round and most people were in favour. Do you know, I think that the royal family are held in great affection by an awful lot of people. It's not trendy to say so, but my view is actually they are. Get over it. Deal with it. People like the monarchy. It has a massive amount of support. All polls consistently show 80% support for the Queen. That's, you know, any politician, any president would absolutely die for that, wouldn't they?
But then maybe if she actually had any realistic power on a day-to-day basis, they may think differently.
Yeah, but she doesn't. That's the point of a constitutional monarchy, you know? She doesn't.
I suppose a lot of people, particularly over the last week or so as well, their big gripe, I guess, against the monarchy is the amount of money that they get from the taxpayers.
Yeah, a certain amount, and it's just gone up, you're quite right.
Exactly.
So it's under $40 million a year at the moment, but that is, it's a lot of money. But
yeah.
Then a lot of work goes on behind the scenes. I mean, the palace is full of people, administrators, dealing with all the work of a monarchy. And do you think a president will be any cheaper? There was some figures published very recently which suggested that the Obamas cost the American people $1.4 billion
Wow, a lot of money. Anyway, shall we get back to making announcements?
The point of this is that if you don't want to announce it on Facebook or Twitter, what can you do? What can you do to make it personal? And these days you can marry the new technology with making it personal by going online. And I did this quite recently for a friend of mine who has lots of money and I didn't know what to get for them. So I went online, downloaded or uploaded, I don't know, the technology, lots of photos, designed my own card, and this is what papershaker.com can do for you, make it look dead professional, put your own greeting in there, and send it off. And that's something permanent and special. And I've got in my kitchen, I've got quite a few of these personalized cards that have been sent to me by my nephews and nieces when they've given birth. And it's a lovely permanent memory. I mean, can you imagine framing a tweet or a Facebook message? It's not going to happen.
If I want to announce anything, I just tell my mum, because she just tells everybody. I don't need Facebook or Twitter. She does the job for me.
Oh, she's going to be very cross with you.
I know she will, but she knows it's true. But I guess most people, you tell your closest, your nearest and dearest, but Twitter and Facebook, it's good for telling everyone else that you don't maybe see on a daily or weekly basis.
Sure, and I don't think that Paper Shaker are saying don't tweet or Facebook, but to those people, you know, relatively close to you, why don't you send out these personalised cards and just make it a little bit special for your nearest and dearest?
Absolutely. And of course, there's plenty of other websites that do it as well.
Indeedy, yes. Yeah, Moonpig, all sorts of, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, thank you so much for speaking to us today. I'm sure we'll be seeing quite a lot of you very soon when the new baby comes along.
Yeah, I should be there, although I have booked a holiday, so I might actually miss it, which would be hilarious.
Oh, well, never mind. I'm sure there'll be more to come. Well, is there any way that our listeners can find out more information?
Yes, you can. The website is papershaker.com. You need to just put a hyphen between paper and shaker.
Okay, brilliant. Well, Jenny, thank you so much for speaking to us today.
Pleasure.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Jane. Radio Cardiff.